G'day all, MrPaladin here, and time for a spy review of DeadlyKitten from the UK, a frequent and long-time community member. So to start off with, Deadly shows a good example of how to understand the enemy sentry gun AI there, knowing that even though he got the stab in front of the gun was still going to shoot him up. He wanted the friendly heal, but there was no trust between him and the medic, and plus they were really busy, they were moving in on the sentry nest anyway. See a little action at the door, but we go up here. I'm not sure if we're checking for snipers or checking to see if the door is open. Either way, we're wanting to get deeper into enemy territory. Now, we've got to be careful because the spawning players will be able to see you through the wall, even though we were hugging it. That engineer looked like he was new. Our spy picked up the health and ammo. I love that look back towards a team, making sure they were good with that medic that was moving in. So we're going to take an alternate route, and we pick up a pyro on a drop stab. Try and find that spy, but we couldn't get him. We're staying close with the team. Now note, we do have that metal nearby, so we're pretty free to do whatever we want here. Taking some shots at the scout. We get a bump on something, the spy was nearby, but quick back to the gun and we kill the engineer. Taking the alternate route to get a better position, pick up some health, reset, we should be good. Have a little look down. There is a sentry gun at a spawn door. Now here's the first play that I don't like from you. You don't go down for this health and ammo after your decloak. Instead, you put yourself right in the middle of their main traffic lane here with no dead ringer ready. I know you're interested in getting that gun that got you, but this is dangerous until now when your ringer is safe again. Should have just gone for the sap on these. Yep, you went for it a little too late. Reset. We pick up an AFK disguise. And this engineer, he's too busy looking at getting his gun up. Easy stab. Distracted heavy. Now remember where we just destroyed that sentry gun, because there's going to be sentry metal there, and I think you can make better use of the drop sentry metal. I see a couple times in this clip where we could have made use of it. Yeah, you can trust us, medic. We make good team. Should have dropped the ringer before dropping down. It triggered our ringer, and now we're here. We're not able to get health. We're not able to replenish the ringer on the payload because we have a disguise. I would have gone back for that health and ammo that we had earlier, but we also missed some sentry ammo, alternate routes, and another health and ammo that I probably would have gone for before going to here. It's no big deal though, you do get the reset, and any of those paths would have been fine. We reset. We'll take the alternate route. We're on a heavy disguise, it is slow. But look out, they're going to have the wall hack as they spawn. And we're not really putting in much acting, we're looking straight at the enemy spawn. So any of them coming out could suspect us, including the guy we're disguised as. I see you recognize that. You went for a stab on the pyro, but you are on a slow disguise, so you get busted by their enemy spy. A crazy pyro coming straight in for the payload. That was a fortunate stab. Wow, that was a risky drop on the ringer right in front of the spinning up heavy. Looks like we do a little dance with another spy back here. But it's okay, it's a hidden area, and I do like that you go straight to the high ground. It's a good position. You get to look down. The enemy pyro and the heavy do see you, but they're in no position to argue. And they don't get much damage on you because of your good position. You escape, and you get the metal fragments, giving you that instant reset on your ringer. I like that you're jumping here to minimize splash. I want you to get into the habit of doing that more. You jump some more here as this pills around. Just jump in general, it's fine. There's a trap. Sometimes your ringer can let you survive through a big trap, sometimes not. I do like this reset. Okay, good position, but bad luck for this spy who happens to bump you on the way through. A pyro does see it though, and you don't notice the pyro. You do see the heavy here, and you decide to go for it, but that pyro had you. One air blast there, you would have been toast. The heavy's okay, he can reset with his sandwich. but I like that you paid attention. Okay, we go for the soldier who is distracted by the payload, and I do like that look back, looking for the sniper who did see you. Going in to protect your team, but he does a rocket jump. No, oh, and he actually lands and gets a critical whip. Good. But your team wins. So all up, I do like that. I would have opted for a couple of the different ammo drops. I think you need to work on your acting though, so let's have a look at that as we go forward. Straight out of the gate here, we hear a sentry. We see it shooting at the scout. So it picks us up. We have to get around it. I do like your caution as you decloak here, making sure that the sentry doesn't pick you up. And the pyro is distracted with what's happening at the payload. Now that we've got the disguise, we can see about this nest. But what's with this sniper? He gave us a bump. I think he's a new player. Okay, watch your acting here. You don't have your ringer up. You're going up the main lane. Well, very careful. That sniper could have had you. I do like that you put the ringer up, though. You do get busted by the same sniper. You're just looking to trigger this ringer, and I'm fine with that. Anything, anything, thank you. I like that you nope out up top, putting you in a good position. Maybe go to the revolver on that pyro. We've got the reset. You go back to the good position. Nice high ground. Hard to get hit here. And you get all your options. You see the distracted sniper. And here's a new sniper again. It gets the heavy killed. He doesn't know what he's seeing. And he's out. Okay, I like this. You've got the ringer up. You have no idea what's up ahead. You're taking a side route. You're in a good position. I like everything about what you're doing here. Well, thanks to you too. Again, unknown. I like you taking the side route. Now, you pop yourself out in front of everyone. You're not acting, okay? The part of acting is you want to look at your own teammate like you're doing there. Maybe you acted right there, I don't know. But do more of that. Good position, you see some enemies. You drop down, there's a pyro behind you. You get the stab and nope out. Pyro is still there. You don't know what's around, keeping the ringer up. But the enemy spy sees you here. He doesn't trust that. I love the fast reset on the middle. Do more of that. The second death is very convincing with the dead ringer. People fall for it all the time. And you get another quick reset off of the metal. And you still have the heavy disguise, which is very good. It's hard to maintain a heavy disguise like that for so long. But you drop it anyway. Your dead ringer got dropped just as you dropped it at the same time as taking damage. You pick up the heavy straight away, but I love what happens here. You see the spy, you drop the heavy disguise in order to get the speed. Love that choice. Spy went the other way. You could have gone to a revolver here on the pyros, but I do like that you baited them into a possible trick stab. Either a stair or a corner right there. Oh, there's a new sniper again. He's good for a disguise. Sorry, mate. Yep, you recognize the fact as well. Payload coming in, did the heavy see us where we busted? We're gonna nope out anyway on that. Okay, now I don't like this choice here. You went for a sap before killing the engineer when you're holding your eternal reward or a Wanga prick. It gives the enemy engineers an automatic call out about a spy. So I prefer what you do here, stab them first, then sap up all his stuff. It's much quieter and you're more likely to get away with it. Lots of metal there. Lots and lots of metal. Okay, yeah, we are cautious because they do have the spawning warhack. Tons of metal here, lots of options. Even though there's lots to pick up here, you nope out all the way to the health, but you miss the health. Doesn't matter, your team pushes it in, but you gave up a lot of good positioning there. So thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Hope to see more demos like this submitted so we can put them up for review. Non più dry farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno girando, delle belle turbando a riposo, ma ci sento a toncino d'amore.